Welcome. This video shows you how to use the Data Interactive for the U.S. Election Assistance Commission's 2022 Election Administration and Voting Survey, or EAVS. This interactive is designed to help users explore EAVS data at the state and county level. This tool is hosted through Microsoft Power BI, which means that anyone with an internet connection can access it. There's no special software required to use this interactive, only an internet browser. You may view the interactive through a web browser, or you may click on the link on the EAC's website to download the full file to your computer and view it there. Some of the navigational tools might be different if you're viewing the file downloaded to your computer, as opposed to viewing the interactive on the EAC's website. You can open the interactive in full screen mode by clicking the button at the bottom right corner of the interactive. You can use the Zoom menu in the bottom right corner to zoom in or out of the page. Most of the elements on the pages of the interactive have a focus mode button at the top right corner of the elements. You can click this focus mode button to zoom in on just that element. To go back and view the entire page, click the button at the top left that reads Back to Report. There are 13 pages within the Data Interactive. Each page has graphs, maps, and tables to help you explore the EAVS data. Within the web browser, you can click the arrows at the bottom of the interactive to proceed to the next page or to go back to a previous page. You can also click on the page count and open a menu that will show you all the pages in the interactive. When you see a map on a page, you can hover your mouse over one of the states or territories to see more details about its EAVS data. You can also click on the states to zoom in on it. For most pages, this will also update the data that you see in the tables and other graphs so that only the selected states is shown. To return to seeing the full map, click on the state again to deselect it. Some pages have drop-down menus you can use to select a state to view. This will also update the data shown in the table and other graphs on the page. To deselect a state that you selected through the drop-down menu, open the menu again and unclick the state. If you want to zoom in on one of the five US territories or the District of Columbia, it may be easiest to select them through the drop-down menu. Most pages will also give you the option to select which data year to view. This interactive has EAVS data for 2018, 2020, and 2022. By default, the interactive will show you data for 2022. To change that, select the radio button for a different year from the blue box near the bottom right corner of the page. Some of the drop-down menus in the pages will let you select other categories. For instance, this page shows data on voters who are covered by the Uniformed and Overseas Citizens Absentee Voting Act, or UOCAVA. The drop-down menu near the top right corner of the page will let you select which type of UOCAVA voter you want to see data on. Data on all UOCAVA voters is selected by default, but you can change that to view data on only overseas citizens or only on uniformed services voters. This will update the data you see in the map, table, and bar graph on this page. The tables you see throughout the Data Interactive can be sorted. For instance, if you want to sort the counties in this table based on how many registered UOCAVA voters they reported, click the Registered header. That will sort the tables so that the counties with the largest number of UOCAVA voters appear first. To sort it so that the counties with the lowest number of UOCAVA voters appear first, click the header again. You can also click on a county within the table. This will highlight the county's data in the graphs and maps on the page. And graphs that show a state-level metric will have the county's data superimposed on the graph. You will need to scroll through the tables and graphs to see all the data that they have. On a table, scroll left and right to view more categories, and scroll up and down to view more counties. On a bar graph, scroll left and right to view more counties. If you have selected a state or county within a table, map, or graph, you should deselect it before making a different selection. If you would like more information about how the percentages shown on any of the pages in the interactive were calculated, refer to the gray box at the bottom of the page. You will need to scroll down within the gray box to read all the notes. The jurisdiction comparison page of the Data Interactive works a little different from other pages. This page allows you to select jurisdictions and directly compare them on ballot transmission and voter turnout. To start, you'll need to choose a baseline jurisdiction or jurisdictions. Use the drop-down menus in the top third of the page to select by state, by county, or by election policy. You can select from multiple menus if you like. The data for your baseline jurisdiction or jurisdictions will appear on the table below the selection menus. Once you have your baseline, you'll then select a set of comparison jurisdictions. Use the drop-down menus in the middle third of the page to select a set of states or counties. Or use the sliders to filter on how many individuals were registered to vote or how many voted in the election. You may use your mouse to drag the slider, or use the text boxes above the sliders to type in your range. The data for your selected comparison jurisdictions will appear in the table on the bottom third of the page. As with other tables in this interactive, you can sort the table by any of the headers. Thank you for using the 2022 EAVS Data Interactive. To download the EAVS data or read the EAC's reports of EAVS findings, visit www.eac.gov. If you have questions about the EAVS, email research@eac.gov.